Hello students, in the previous class we have learnt about integers and addition of integers. Let's revise it. While adding integers, we must follow some rules of addition. So what is the first rule? This I have explained in the last class also. The first rule is, when adding integers with the same sign, ignore the sign and add the numbers. Then give the common sign to their sum. That means what? If given numbers are having same sign, suppose for example here, so both the integers are positive, correct? The given integers are positive. So what you should do if both the numbers are positive? So ignore the sign, don't see the sign. Just see the number 2 and 3. So add the numbers 2 plus 3, that is 5. Okay, ignore the sign, then add the numbers, then give the common sign to their sum. That means give the common sign. That means here both the numbers are having which sign? Positive sign. So give positive sign to their sum. Okay, similarly here, second example, here both the numbers are negative. So here also you have to apply same rule. If both the numbers are negative, ignore the sign, don't see the sign. So add the numbers 1 plus 3, total is 4. Then give the sum with sign, common sign. Here both the numbers are having which sign? Negative sign. So give negative sign to their sum. Okay, now second rule is, when adding integers with different signs, if the given numbers, maybe one is positive and the other one is negative, so how to add these numbers? So ignore the sign and subtract the smaller number from the bigger one. Then give the sign of the bigger number to the difference obtained. That means, for example, now see here one number is positive, other one is negative. So first, what you should do, ignore the sign, don't see the sign now, only see the numbers 1 and 3. Okay, what you should do, just you subtract smaller number from bigger number. That means 3 minus 1, what is the difference? 2 you will get, correct? Then which sign we should give? The bigger number sign. Here the bigger number, only see the number, don't see the sign. 1 and 3, take 1 and 3 number. So which is the bigger number here? 3 is bigger number, correct? So bigger number has which sign? Negative sign. So to the difference obtained, give bigger number sign. Understood? Similarly, next example, see here also this is negative and this is positive. So what you should do, ignore the sign, subtract smaller number from bigger number. 4 minus 1 is 3. Here bigger number is 4, correct? It has which sign? Plus sign. So give positive sign to the difference obtained. Okay, now let's go to the practice set. Now practice set 5, the first question is add addition of integers. So 8 plus 6, here both the numbers are positive, correct? So if both the numbers are positive, what you should do? Add the numbers and give same sign. So 8 plus 6 is, sum is 14. So which sign we should give? Same, positive. So plus 14, correct? Now next, here one number is positive, other is negative. You have to apply second rule here. So one number is positive, other is negative. So what we should do? Ignore the sign, then subtract smaller number from bigger number. So 9 minus 3, how much? 6, correct? Then which sign we should give to the difference obtained? Bigger number sign. Here bigger number is 9. It has which sign? Positive sign. So plus 6, correct? Next, 5 plus minus 6. Here also one number is positive, other is negative. So same rule you have to apply. So first subtract smaller number from bigger number. 6 minus 5, 1. And which sign we should give? Bigger number sign. Bigger number is here 6. It has which sign? Minus. So give negative sign. Next, here also one is negative, other is positive, correct? So if one number is positive, other is negative, what you should do? Subtract smaller number from bigger number. 7 minus 2, how much? 5. So then which sign we should give? Bigger number sign. Bigger number is here 7. It has negative sign. Now next, minus 8 plus 0. So minus 8 plus 0 is, here also one is positive, other is negative. So subtract, 8 minus 0 is 8. So bigger number is here, 8. So which sign we should give? Bigger number sign, negative. Next, here, minus 5 plus minus 2. Here, both the numbers are negative. Correct. So if both the numbers are negative, what we should do? Ignore the sign, add the numbers. Correct. So 5 plus 2, 7 total. So then give common signs. First rule you have to apply. Give common sign, that is negative. So negative 7. Now next, question number 2. Complete the table given below. So here what is given? Minus 2 plus 8. Minus 2 plus 8. So 1 is negative, other number is, integer is positive. Correct. So apply second rule. 1 is positive, other is negative. What you should do? Subtract smaller number from bigger number by ignoring signs. 8 minus 2 is 6. Your bigger number is 8. So it has positive sign. So give positive sign to the difference obtained. Now next one is minus 2 plus 4. Minus 2 plus 4. Correct. So what is the answer? Here 1 is negative, other one is positive. So subtract first. 4 minus 2. 2 answer. Correct. Then which sign we should give? Bigger number sign. Bigger number is here 4. It has positive sign. Plus 2. Correct. Next, minus 2 plus minus 3. Minus 2 plus minus 3. So what is the answer? Here both the numbers are negative. That means numbers having same sign. If the numbers are having same sign, what we should do? Ignore the sign, add the numbers. 2 plus 3, sum is 5. Then give common sign to their sum. So common sign means here negative. Both the numbers are negative, so give negative sign. Next, minus 2 plus minus 5. So here also both the numbers are negative. Add the numbers by ignoring sign. You will get sum is 7. Then give common sign, that is negative. Next question number 2. Next question. 6 plus 8. 6 plus 8. Both are positive. So 6 plus 8 is how much? 14. So which sign? Positive. Both the numbers are positive. So add and give positive sign. Here also both the numbers are positive. So add the numbers and give positive sign. Next, 6 plus minus 3. Here 1 is positive, other is negative. Numbers having different sign. So ignore the sign. Subtract smaller number from bigger number. 6 minus 3. So what is the answer? You will get 3. Here bigger number is 6. So give the bigger number sign, that is plus. Next, here also 1 is positive, other is negative. So subtract 6 minus 5. What is the answer? 1. And which sign we should give to the difference obtained? Bigger number sign. So bigger number is 6. It has positive sign. Plus 1. Next, 0 plus 8. 0 plus 8 is how much? 8. So plus 8. Next, 0 plus 4. 4. You can write 4 or plus 4. Next, 0 plus minus 3. Here 1 is positive and other one is negative. So subtract. So subtract 3 minus 0 is 3. Then here bigger number is 3. It has which sign? Minus sign. So give negative sign. Here also 1 is positive, other one is negative. So which rule we should apply? Ignore the sign. Subtract smaller number from bigger number. 5 minus 0. So what is the answer? 5. And sign, which sign we should give? Here bigger number is 5. It has negative sign. So give negative sign. Next one is minus 4 plus 8. Minus 4 plus 8. One is negative, other one is positive. So subtract 8 minus 4. So 4. So your bigger number is 8. It has positive sign. Give bigger number sign. Okay. Then here minus 4 plus 4. One is positive, other one is negative. So subtract 4 minus 4, 0. Here which sign you should give? But remember students, 0 does not have any sign. Don't put here minus 0 or plus 0. So 0 does not have any sign. Next, -4 plus -3. Here the given numbers are, both the numbers are negative. If both the numbers are negative, what you should do? Ignore the sign, add the numbers. 4 plus 3, how much? 7. And which sign we should give? Common sign, that is negative. Correct? Then here -4, -4 plus -5. -4 plus -5. So both the numbers are negative. If both the numbers are negative, ignore the sign, add the numbers. 4 plus 5, total how much? 9. And give common sign to their sum. Common sign means here negative. Both the numbers are negative, no? So give negative signs. Okay? Now let's see what are opposite numbers. Okay, now look at this number line, students. Now you imagine that now you are at zero position. Okay, now if you move 3 units to the right, 3 units means what? 1, 2, 3. So if you move 3 units to the right, then you will reach a number plus 3. Correct? Or if you move 3 units to the left, 1, 2, 3. If you move 3 units to the left, then you will reach a number minus 3. Right? If you move 3 units to the right from 0, then you will reach the number plus 3. If you move 3 units to the left, then you will reach the number minus 3. But now, see, both the numbers, plus 3 and minus 3, these two numbers are at same distance from 0. Now what is the distance between 0 and plus 3? 3 cm. What is the distance between 0 and minus 3? 1, 2, 3. 3 cm. Correct? That means the distance, the both the numbers, that is plus 3 and minus 3, are at same distance from 0 on the number line. But they are in opposite direction. See, this is in opposite direction. Plus 3 is in this direction and minus 3 is in reverse direction. Correct? So these numbers are called opposite numbers. Which numbers? Minus 3 and plus 3 are called opposite numbers. So opposite numbers means what? The numbers which are at same distance from 0 on the number line but in opposite directions are called opposite numbers. Here in this number line, so which are the opposite numbers? Plus 3 and minus 3 are opposite numbers. Now if you add these two numbers, opposite numbers, what is the sum of two opposite numbers? For example, plus 3 plus minus 3, what is the sum of these two numbers? 0. The sum of two opposite numbers is 0. Understood? Now, what is the opposite of plus 3? Opposite of plus 3 is minus 3. What is the opposite of plus 4? Opposite of plus 4 is minus 4. You have to change the sign. If it is given plus, you should write minus. If it is given minus, you should write plus. What is the opposite of minus 6? The opposite of minus 6 is plus 6. Understood now? What are opposite numbers? Now, let's go to the practice set now. Practice set 6. Write the opposite number of each of the numbers given below. Okay, here numbers are given in one row and you should write down the opposite of that number. Here 47 is given. 47 means if sign is not given, that means it is considered as a positive number. So what is the opposite of 47? Just change the sign, minus 47. Okay, then here plus 52. So if it is given plus, what you should write opposite? Minus 52. Then minus 33. What is the opposite of minus 33? Plus 33. Change the number sign. Then what is the opposite of minus 84? Plus 84. Then what is the opposite of minus 21? Plus 21. What is the opposite of plus 16? Minus 16. What is the opposite of minus 26? Plus 26. What is the opposite of 80? 80 is a positive number, so minus 80. Now let's see how to compare the integers. So comparing integers. Students, you know how to compare the numbers. You have learnt in 5th standard. Correct? So, how to compare the numbers using less than or greater than or equal sign. By using that sign, so we can say which number is bigger and which number is smaller. Similarly here, how to compare the integers? You have to say which integer is bigger and which integer is smaller. Correct? Now, so you have to remember 2 points here while comparing integers. So, what is the first point? Of any two numbers on the number line, the one on the left is the smaller number. That means, now look at this, this is the number line, correct? This is 0 and here positive numbers are written and this is the left side of 0, negative numbers are there, correct? So, what is the meaning of this sentence? If you take any two integers, now see for example, I have taken here plus 2 and plus 7, correct? Now, you have to compare these two integers. You have to say which one is bigger and which one is smaller. So, see on the number line, you can, by seeing the number line, you can tell which one is bigger and which one is smaller. Now, you remember of two, any two numbers on the number line. The one on the left is the smaller number. That means here plus 2. Plus 2 is here and plus 7 is here. Correct? Here plus 2 is left of plus 7. Correct? Plus 2 is the left of plus 7. That means the left side which number is there, na? That is the smaller number. You know that. So always this right side numbers are positive numbers and left side numbers are negative numbers. Positive numbers are greater and negative numbers are smaller. So plus 2 and plus 7. So plus 2 is left of plus 7. That means this is smaller and this is bigger. Plus 7 is bigger. Correct. That means plus 2 is less than plus 7. Correct. Or you know, if the, both the numbers are positive numbers are given here. So the number which is bigger, that is greater. Correct. Then next example, minus 5 and minus 2. Here both the numbers are, both the integers are negative here. Correct. So both the integers are negative. The smaller number is the bigger. Remember, if both the numbers are negative, then the smaller number is a bigger. If both the numbers are positive, then bigger number is a bigger. Understood, students? If both the numbers are positive, then bigger number is the bigger. If both the numbers are negative, then smaller number is the bigger. That means minus 5 is less than minus 2. So on the number line, you can see here. See, minus 5 is here, minus 2 is here. Now see, I said that the left side numbers are always smaller. Here minus 5 is the minus 5 is left of minus 2. Correct? Yes. The minus 5 is left of minus 2. That means this is the smaller number. Minus 5 is smaller. Minus 2 is bigger. So minus 5 is less than minus 2. Now next one is, if one number is positive and other one is negative. That you know. So positive numbers are always greater than the negative numbers. So plus 4 is greater than minus 5. Or on the number line also you can see here. Plus 4 is here, minus 5 is here. Correct? Plus 4 is here, minus 5. So minus 5 is left of plus 4. Left side it is there, no? Minus 5 is there. It is left of plus 4. That means minus 5 is the smaller number. Correct? So minus 5 is less than plus 4 or plus 4 is greater than minus 5. So here plus 4 is, which sign will come? Plus 4 is greater than minus 5. Understood, students? So, or you can remember like this. If both the given integers are positive, then bigger number is the bigger. If both the given integers are negative, then the smaller number is the bigger. Then if one number is positive and the other one is negative, the positive number is bigger number. Next, second one. Any negative integer is smaller than 0. Now you know, negative numbers or negative integers are smaller than 0. and positive integers are greater than 0, correct? So any negative integer is smaller than 0 and any positive integer is greater than 0. For example, here -2. -2 is negative number, correct? Negative numbers are smaller than 0, less than 0. 0 is greater. And here 5. So it is a positive number. Positive numbers are greater than 0. 5 is greater than 0. Okay, understood students how to compare the integers? Now, so we will go to the practice set now. Practice set 7. So what is given here? Write the proper signs greater than, less than or equal in the boxes below. The first question is -4-5. So this is a negative number, this is a positive number. You know that positive numbers are always greater than the negative number. That means -4 is less than 5. Correct? Then 8 and -10. Here also one is positive, other one is negative. So 8 is positive number. That means positive number is greater than -10. Correct? Next, +9 and +9. So both the numbers are equal. So which sign we should put here? It's equal sign. Next, -6 and 0. So -6 is less than 0 or greater than 0. -6 is a negative number. So negative numbers are always smaller than 0. So -6 is less than 0. Next, 7 and 4. 7, both the numbers are positive here. So if both the numbers are positive, bigger number is bigger. That means 7 is greater than 4. Next, 3 and 0. So which is bigger one here? So this is a positive number. So positive numbers are greater than 0. So 3 is greater than 0. Next, -7 and 7. This is a negative number, this is a positive number. So the positive number is bigger now. That means this is smaller. -7 is less than 7. Next, -12 and 5. This is a negative number, this is a positive number. So negative numbers are less than positive numbers. So negative number, -12 is less than 5. Next, -2 and -8. Here both the numbers are negative. I said if both the numbers are negative, the smaller number is the bigger. So which is bigger here? -2 is greater than -8. Okay. So on the number line also you can see here. -2 is here. But -8 is here. Correct. So this is -8. This is -8. Here -8 is left of -2. That means -8 is a smaller number. Correct. -2 is bigger. Okay. So -2 is greater than -8. Next, 10th one. -1 and -2. So which is bigger one here? -1 and -2. So -1 is greater. Correct. Smaller one is bigger. -1 is greater than -2. Next, 6 and -3. This is positive number, this is negative number. Correct. So which is bigger? Positive number is bigger. Next, -14, -14. So both the numbers are equal. Correct. So which sign we should put here? So equal sign. Students, today we have learned about addition of integers, opposite numbers and comparison of integers. I hope you all understood the lesson. The continuation of this lesson will be taught in the next class. Thank you.